السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Dear respected brothers, dear sisters, we are there. May Allah سبحانه وتعالى accept our salah. Amin ya rahman rahim. أسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى رب أن يتقبل منا وإياكم صالح الأعمال وأن يوفقنا وإياكم لما يحب ويرضى. May Allah سبحانه وتعالى get all of us to please Him to make something good in our life for the real future, which is our hereafter. Afterlife, inshallah. As an insan or human, a human, see the philosophy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, really. We have Islamic philosophy. Maybe somebody can say, what's philosophy you're talking about? We have Islamic, falsafa islamiyya, we used to study this. Yeah, Islamic philosophy. We used to study that. Behind some wisdom of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, too many things we have to study to understand. As an insan or a human, you are from five things. Me, say Jumaa. Who say Jumaa? I am a body. You too, you have that body. You have inside that body your spirit, your ruh, and your nafs. Both they are different. You have nafs, and you have spirit, and you have your brain inside your body. And you have, number five, your heart, which is the king of your. And the heart, now if you read a lot about too many searches or search in the internet, more than 40 million cells in your body just for understanding, in your heart for understanding. You understand it from your heart. It is not from your brain. But let's see in very short, kida, the job of each part of your body, about your body as a organs or your body or your feature in general. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talk about it in the Quran. But is that very important? It is not important. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He described the hypocrite people or the munafiq, He said, وَإِذَا رَأَيْتُهُمْ تُعْجِبُكَ أَجْسَامُهُمْ. Subhanallah. وَإِنْ يَقُولُوا تَسْمَعْ لِقَوْلِهِمْ كَأَنَّهُمْ خُشُوٌ مُسَنَّدًا. Yeah, فالمنافق, his body, Allah said his body can please you. When he speaks, you can listen to him. He has sweet tongue. For the body is not, doesn't is not important. And in the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the hadith said that إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَنْظُرُ إِلَى صُوَرِكُمْ وَلَا أَجْسَدِكُمْ. Allah is not looking at your features, your short or tall or fat or skinny. No, and Allah is not looking at your feature and your body. He's looking at your heart. And he said, وَالتَّقْوَى هَا هُنَا وَالتَّقْوَى هَا هُنَا وَالتَّقْوَى هَا هُنَا. He appointed three times to his heart, and he said, the taqwa of Allah, it is in your heart. The body is nothing. Body is nothing. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He will punish the kuffar, the disbelievers in the hellfire, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make their figure big, huge. I read some hadith, the seat of the kafir in the hellfire, like the distance between Mecca and the Medina. His tooth, one of his teeth, like the mountain of Uhud, its size. His skin will be very thick. Why? ليذوق العذاب. To test, to feel the punishment. The feature of the mu'min also will be, you know that, mashallah, you know this hadith, all of you, mashallah. قال تبعثون يوم القيامة على هيئة أبيكم آدم 60 ذراعا في السماء. And the day of judgment, Allah will resurrect you like the height of your Adam, your father Adam, 60 yards, like 45 meters your height, inshallah, there, by 7. MashaAllah. But in your feature, yeah, your face, Allah will beautify you more. And subhanAllah, and you're going to be in the age of Sayyidina Isa. The beauty of Yusuf? No, the beauty of Adam. Adam, Allah give him all the beauty. Yusuf, 50% of the beauty, Allah give it to him. Now, the point here, the body is not important. But the body carrying everything. But it's important, but for Allah, doesn't matter. Number two, your soul. And the soul, we talk about it, it's seven types of souls. Khabisa, wal-lawama, wal-kaza. And your soul, it's your enemy. Be careful. Your soul, like a crazy child. Crazy, crazy. If you did not train your soul to be in the right track, your soul gonna give you a hard time. Gonna make you crazy. That's why we have seven types of radiya, al-mardiya, al-kamil, the perfect one, al-mulhama, the inspired one, and the blaming one, al-khabisa one, al-lawama one, all of this soul. But now we talk about the body, about the soul. Very short, I don't want to talk more about them. Talk about the ruh, about your ruh. I will leave it to the end because this is my topic about it today. Okay? About your brain. What about your brain? Your brain, nothing. Your brain is just collecting information. And your brain, if your brain, you know, gonna be, يعني, in corruption, your body also, خلاص, that's it, dead. But the job of the brain to collect information, to send information. That's it, nothing else. Like the, what they call it in the computer, what is the part in the computer collecting brain. Information?
Hard drive.
Yes, the hard drive of the computer. Yeah, collecting. Sometimes it freeze, it's full. That's why you have to take it easy, you know, to release yourself. But this is the job of the brain. But sometimes the brain knows the right and the wrong, and they still doing the wrong thing. If you ask your brain, smoking is haram or halal? I said, don't worry about it. I can get to a sheikh, he can say halal, haram, halal. But don't worry about the sheikh. If you smoke or you eat drugs, you deal with the drugs, that's gonna harm your body or not? His brain say, of course, it's a big harm. The boy is still smoking. Why? I said, khalas, because he knows the right and the wrong, and he's still doing the wrong thing. Why? Because the king is sleeping. The king, the heart, and this is number five. If your heart is healthy, إِلَّا مَنْ أَتَى اللَّهَ بِقَلْبٍ سَلِيمٍ, like what the Quran said, you come to Allah with a healthy heart. Healthy means is not, I'm talking about physically. Yeah, and physically is good too, but I'm talking about the iman in your heart, the understanding in your heart. Why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala appointed too many of jinn and the ins to the hellfire? Quran said it. وَلَقَدْ ذَرَأْنَا لِجَهَنَّمَ كَثِيرًا مِنَ الْجِنِّ وَالْإِنسِ. لَيْ رَبْ رَبِّنَا Allah answered. He said, because لَهُمْ قُلُوبٌ لَا يَعْقِلُونَ بِهِ. لَهُمْ قُلُوب, you have عَقْل here. He said, no, the عَقْل is here. لَهُمْ قُلُوبٌ لَا يَعْقِلُونَ. The sense in the heart not here. لهم قلوب لا يعقلون بها وأذان لا يسمعون بها وأعين لا يبصرون بها إن هم إلا كالأنعام بل هم أضل أولئك هم الغافلون. Because of that they are heedless, they are like animals, even worse. They are غافلون, they have no understanding in their hearts. Allah appointed too many of the ins and jinn, human and jinn, to the hellfire. For the heart is the master of your body, is the king of your body. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that, أَلَا إِنَّ فِي الْجَسَدِ مُضْغَةً إِذَا فَسَدَتْ فَسَدَ الْجَسَدِ وَإِذَا صَلُحَتْ صَلُحَ الْجَسَدِ. There is a part, organ in your body. If it is healthy, your brain, your body will be healthy. Healthy means you have iman and taqwa and your heart. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if you read the whole entire Quran, Allah is talking to directly to your brain or to your arm or to your eyes or to your... No, Allah is talking directly to your heart. إِلَّا مَنْ أَتَى اللَّهَ بِقَلْبٍ لَهُمْ قُلُوبٌ لَا. وآيات كثيرة بقى هو بقول لك إيه, إنها لا تعمل إيه الأبصار ولكن تعمل قلوب التي في الصدور. The blind one is not the one who's blind here. The one who's blind here in his heart. ولكن تعمل قلوب التي في الصدور. ألم نشرح لك صدرك.
So the heart as the physical, right?
Both.
So physical.
Both, because Imam al-Ghazali, when he talk about the heart, he said it is not this muscle or this. Oh, okay. No, it is something in your chest. But I disagree with him. It has a relationship with the heart, the muscle too. Because nowadays doctors and the researchers in the medical field, they say too many things. They said there are too many cells in the heart for the understanding, and they are talking about. And subhanAllah, how do you get the feeling? Subhanallah. When you read the Quran, you listen to the Quran, Allah said that. فمن شرح الله صدره means his heart للإسلام فهو سبحان الله فهو على نور من رب فهو القصية قلوبهم من ذكر الله أولئك في ضلال مبين. الله نزل أحسن الحديث كتابا متشابها المثاني تقشعر منه جلود الذين ثم تلين جلودهم وقلوبهم إلى ذكر الله. When you listen to the Quran, Quran will soften your heart and your skin to the remembrance of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. Sometimes you see goosebumps and sometimes you see like, سبحان الله, you feel like cold or you feel shivering when you listen to the Quran, because the Quran affecting your heart and your skin. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said. Let's come to the your ruh. Your body can be old. When you see these guys, those who are sitting in the chair, they're getting old, halas. Dr. Ibrahim is the third one. And Samir Kamoud, they are listening now. Okay. See, when you get old, Abu Ahmed, your body can be old. Sah? Your body can be old. Ya Abi Sanda, Ya Abi Braza Qasim. Your body can be old. طيب, the question is your ruh can be old? Your spirit, not the nafs. Nafs is different from the ruh. Is your spirit can be old like your body?
No.
No? It's of course a big no. Yes. Your ruh can never be old and getting shaykhukha or getting big, yani older like your body. Yeah, the body is the qalib, it's the market, it's the ride of your ruh. Your ruh is still young. That's why the ruh will last to the no end. The ruh will last. And the ruh, when Allah created you, ruh, that's color, they said that it's bigger than the body. That's why it goes into the body with the force. And subhanAllah, when the ruh will come out from the body also, by force. That's why like sakarat al-maut, the pain of death. Why the angels, 500 angels, they are working with the angel of death to treat the ruh from your toes here, to your knees, to your waist, and to your chest, and to your throat, and the malak al-maut will take. But for the moment, inshallah, Allah will make it easy for him. Like the drop of the water, it's easy, inshallah. Like the hair in the dog. It will be easy for the moment, inshallah. But the point here is, ruh, ya jamaa. The question is, the question is, yani, subhanAllah, do you have to wait until your ruh will go out from your body to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? This is my point today. Do you have to wait until you die, your ruh? Do you agree with me? Can you meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala every day? Can you talk to Allah every day?
Yes.
Your ruh can go to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala every day? Actually, your ruh is going to Allah every night. When we sleep, the minor sleep, this is called the minor death. We sleep every night, your ruh is going out from your body. Yes, Allah said in the Quran, Allah يتوفى الأنفس حين موتها والتي لم تمت في منامها فيمسك التي قضى عليها الموت ويرسل الأخرى إلى أجل مسمى. Means your ruh will go out every night to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We die. Rasulullah SAW said, الموت أخو النوم أو النوم أخو الموت. The sleep is a brother of death. Rasulullah said that in the hadith. Huh? النوم أخو الموت. They are brothers. Your ruh is going out every night, coming back to your body every night, every day. فسبحانallah, you don't have to die to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why when you come to salah, you are in a meeting with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with your ruh. Huh? When you make sadaqah, the same. When you read the Quran, the same. When you make any kind of good deeds, the same. You are meeting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. SubhanAllah, Allah is finding there. You are there. That's why your ruh is very important, ya jamaa. Ruh, when we die, Allah will not take your body to him up to the seven heaven. Your ruh, since your ruh will be out of your body, the malaika, inshallah, of rahmah, ya Rabbi, malaika al-jannah, inshallah, they will take it in hanut from al-jannah, hadith long hadith. And they will go seven after heaven, until they will go to up to the seven heaven to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and your ruh will be presented to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah will talk to your ruh. منها خلقناكم وفيها نعيدكم ومنها نخرجكم تارة أخرى. From this earth, Allah created us, and He returned you back to it, and He will resurrect you again. أعدوه إلى الأرض, returning him back to the earth. But you look at this presentation, because your ruh used to meet Allah سبحانه وتعالى every day in the salah and the prayer and the عمل الصالح and Quran and all of that. Your ruh will be presented to Allah. It's a big honor. السلام. It's a big honor. And Allah will honor that ruh with this big presentation, and the ruh will be above the body while the people carrying you to the grave, and the ruh will say, happy, jumping, قدموني, قدموني, go ahead. That's it, like, he's running, he's very light. The ruh, that power, and the ruh, it's a power. Do you know like what? You cannot see it. Allah said that in the Quran. Did you see the electrons in this wire of this electricity? Can you catch it? Can you see it? That's why I like the philosophy of when I say the body and the ruh, like this lamp, subhanAllah, exactly. Allah said, وَيَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنِ الرُّوحِ قُلِ الرُّوحِ مِنْ أَمْرِ رَبِّي. They ask you about the Ruh, oh Muhammad, the Jewish people, when they came to ask Rasul. Tell them, the one he knows about it, it's affair, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nobody knows about it. They try to take picture, they try to x-rays, see somebody's died, couldn't do anything. For Ruh, it is exactly the power, like this electrons in this wire. And the body like this lamp. Say the electrons and the electricity, it is in a wire, but the lamp will be broken. Do you get in light? Exactly. If your body will be broken and still the ruh there, the electricity, you will not leave. You will die. No light. They exactly the same. Likewise, the same. That's why the body must be, if somebody crashed somebody in his head and he died. Why the ruh can leave the body? Because the body is broken, like the lamp. The electricity is there, the power is there, but there is no light. See, the lamp must fit the ruh or the electricity to work together. The point here is you can meet with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala every day. And Allah said that last ayah in Surah Al-Kahf, we read it every week here. What did Allah say? The last ayah in Surah Al-Kahf. فَمَنْ كَانَ يَرْجُو لِقَاءَ رَبِّهِ If you really looking for meeting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala while He's happy with you, فَلْيَعْمَلْ عَمَلًا صَالِحًا وَلَا يُشْرِكْ بِعِبَادَةِ رَبِّهِ أَحَدًا. And this book, these are the two conditions of the acceptance of your good deeds. Number one, al-ikhlas. Number two, al-mutaba'ah. When you make any kind of good deed, make ikhlas. فَلْيَعْمَلْ عَمَلًا صَالِحًا. Al-ikhlas, وَلَا يُشْرِكْ بِعْبَدَةِ رَبِّهِ أَحَدًا. When you make good deed. طيب. Al-mutaba'ah means to follow Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And your amal will not be saliha, according to the ayah. Until or except your amal must match the way of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. يبقى هنا الإخلاص والمتابعة. The ayah said it. فمن كان يرجو لقاء ربي, if you really want to meet Allah while He's happy of you, pleasing Him, full of pleasure, inshallah, from Him, what? اعمل عمل صالح, follow Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and ولا يشرك بعبادة ربه أحدا, إخلاص, sincerity. These are the two conditions of the acceptance of Allah. This is our story in يعني shortcut. I'm asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala inshallah to guide our ruh and our body, our brain and our heart is very important to make good deeds and to come near to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Qasim bhai.
Sheikh, you said that in the night time the ruh go to Allah, right?
Yes. It's not to Allah, to the first heaven.
Okay, the first go, the ruh go.
Yeah.
When the people die, you said the 500, you know,
angels,
they are taking the ruh from two.
Yes.
Yeah. So, when the night time the ruh go, it go itself, or the angel take out and something.
I think it's not going itself because the ayah said Allah yatawaffa al-anfus. Allah yatawaffa means it's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the one who make it. It is not going itself. Nothing going itself. Behind everything, something pushing it, something. It's the qudra of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why he did not say al-malaika or something. He said, قُلْ يَتَوَفَّكُمْ مَلَكُ الْمَوْتِ. مَلَكُ الْمَوْتِ will take your ruh, يَتَوَفَّكُمْ. But in this ayah, he said, Allah يَتَوَفَّ الْأَنفُسِ. Allah, the one who caused you to die while you're sleeping, and then he released your ruh, the ruh to your body again. If you read the tafsir of this ayah, exactly like what I said.
Even if you think about it, it's kind of like, as your example, when you said, like, the ruh, you know, once it's seen the body is down, the ruh will go away, right? But you're still alive as you're asleep.
Right.
But the ruh, as you said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take it. So it's not like the same.
Because the ruh,
right?
One is, for me, it is power, it is energy. And if you lay down, the body is not moving. So that energy can make you crazy. That doesn't, even while you're sleeping, the ruh will refuse to stay in the body. Because your body is not moving. The ruh's job is to move your body. That's why when you're laying down, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make that sunnah for you to take rest. I will take the ruh out. And also to remind you about your death. You're dying every day. That's why I love the tafsir of the ayah. Look at the tafsir of the ayah. Allah said, Allah yatawaffa al-anfus hina mawtaha. When we sleep, we die. You take the ruh out from our bodies. And if somebody will die the real death, the malaika will hold his ruh and he will release the rest to the people. That's why you're like, hey, the man was sleeping and his wife was walking him up for work and the man died. That's just like that. والتي فيمسك التي قضى عليها الموت. He will hold these anfus which is already written. خلاص this is their time. ويرسل الأخرى and he released the rest إلى أجل مسمى to appointed time. إلى أجل مسمى. This is the meaning of the ayah. Yeah. فالله سبحانه وتعالى he make that for us as a reminder too. We're dying every day to see the capability of Allah is Qadir. If he take the ruh every day and return it back to you. Why even when we sneeze we say Alhamdulillah? Do you know why? When we sneeze. Exactly. Because the heart stops in this second. And who run the heart again? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But like when you sneeze, you cannot open your eyes. If you open your eyes will go out from your body. Ayyuh Allah sahih. Subhanallah, during that time, your body became like sukoon in this second when you sneeze. Like this in this second. And subhanallah, when you finish, Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah, because your heart is still, Allah gave you the life again. Yeah, فسبحانallah. Allah, يعني كيف أقول سبحانه وتعالى. What's your question, Rabbi Ahmed? ليش واي؟ I said one is him. One of my eyes is open, another one. Why? Why?
Just in case.
You have a thief there. Or... Okay. Let's make dua, inshallah. Yalla. اللهم يا ربنا استجب دعانا واشف مرضانا ورد خيفك رجانا يا رب العالمين ثبتنا على الإيمان والهدى والتقى يا أرحم الراحمين ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب يا رب العالمين حرم أجسادنا عن النار يا الله حرم وجوهنا عن النار يا رب حرم قلوبنا عن النار يا رب حرم أجسادنا عن النار اللهم اهد قلوبنا واشرح صدورنا للإسلام والإيمان وثبتنا عليه يا أرحم الراحمين اغفر لنا ولوالدينا ولمن كان له حق علينا واستر على اولادنا وعلى بناتنا وعلى اهلينا يا رب العالمين
امين يا رب
اللهم يا رب اشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين
اجمعين يا رب
ومرضى المسلمين واغفر لابائنا ولامهاتنا كما ربينا صغيرا يا رب العالمين وصلى الله على محمد وعلى اله وصحبه وسلم جزاكم الله خيرا